Get ready to match the stars. Ron Palillo, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Riley, Joanne Wally, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
All together now.
Hooray for Holly!
Welcome back, Rayburn.
Welcome back, Rayburn!
Not bad, huh?
Yeah.
No rehearsal or anything. Very good.
You know whose birthday it is today?
Whose birthday?
My husband, Roger Perry.
Happy birthday to Roger Perry. We can't sing it because it cost us money.
No, I'm going to get him some new teeth for his birthday.
You got some in your hand.
Oh, maybe. Wait a minute.
All right, if you're all quite ready, let's say hello to... Oh, what's that?
She ate some candy and pulled her teeth out. Just 5 minutes ago.
No, I really did.
She did.
Would you call my dentist, please?
Thank you. In the meantime, let's hang on to
you guys.
Carol Bittick. How are you, Carol? She's our current champ.
Carol has 6,800
to her credit.
I should be able to do it.
And as time expired last time, she had already started the Big Money Super Match and did the first part of it, the audience match, and won the $500, and that means she's going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000. Are you ready for that, Carol?
Sure am.
Okay, we'll have a go at that in a moment or so, but right now let's have a go at this.
Changed overnight.
Back home, I think.
Here we are with Carol Bittick, who, as I pointed out, is 6,800, won the first part of the audience match, another 500. Now she's going to play for $5,000. Remember, Carol, you've got to match one celebrity exactly in order to collect.
I'm going to stick with my sweetheart, Charles.
Charles, are you ready?
I'm aflame with jealousy.
All right. Swing around, face me, Carol. Here it is. It's worth $5,000. And it goes like this. Hammer and blank. Hammer and blank. Hammer and blank. Now, Carol. His answer is in the slot, and you get your ESP going. Give us an answer which you think will match his. What do you say to that? Hammer and...
Nails.
Hammer and nails. Okay. That's what she says, Charles. And if she does indeed match you, it means she will be...
Oh, first of all, it's one of the hardest ones I've ever encountered.
Really?
There's hammer and pastrami.
Yeah.
Hammer and grasshopper, which is
hammer and sickle.
Hammer and eggs. I forgot that one.
Yeah.
Hammer and bacon.
But even a blank would write hammer and nail.
Yeah! Congratulations. This gal now has $11,800. Well, Carol, would you say it was worth the trip from North Carolina to come up here and have a go at it?
Triple, double, quadruple.
Are you having any laughs in addition to the cash?
Yeah.
Good for you. Now, let's meet your new challenger. Here comes Gail Clower.
One of my favorites.
Gail and Carol, I guess you know each other. And we'll find out about you now.
Okay. I'm from Durham, North Carolina.
Oh. Durham, North Carolina.
Uh-huh.
No kidding.
No kidding. And I'm a happy housewife. Have 4 children, 2 boys and 2 girls, and I'm glad to be here today.
Well, we're glad to have you, Gail. The very best of luck to you. Shall
Thank
we begin?
You.
Okay, here we go. A or B?
B.
B it is, and away we go. The brain surgeon was shocked.
Why?
Why?
When he opened up Dumb Dora's head, he didn't find a brain. Instead, he found a sign that said, blank.
He found a sign that said what?
Found a sign that said blank.
He would accuse
don't fight, children.
Me of copying. Oh.
Very good. Put that in the slot. That's a good one.
Hi.
Hello there. I just came up here to act as a referee.
The doctor will be back in an hour. He had to go to the hospital.
Is he sick?
No, but we are.
Okay, that's good. Good. All right. Everybody ready down here? Just put it in the slot, Brett. And don't, no embellishments, please. We don't have that much time. Gail, the brain surgeon was shocked. When he opened up Dumb Dora's head, he didn't find a brain. Instead, he found a sign that said, blank.
Out to lunch.
Out to lunch. That's pretty good, Ron, right?
You are truly terrific.
Why do you say that?
Out to lunch.
Out to lunch. There's one for Dale. What do you say?
I say that little devil Dumb Dora always dealt with a short deck, didn't she?
Yes, she did, indeed.
I think this is a match if they're not going to get cranky. I said nobody home. Isn't that like out to...
Yeah. Nice try, though. We appreciate your spirit. Charles? Ha!
And soft shoulders is not a match either. Out to lunch.
Out to lunch. Keeper Gale. When the brain surgeon opened up Dumb Dora's head, he didn't find a brain. Instead, he found a sign that said, out to lunch. What do you say, Joanne?
I say, what happened to Dumb Donald? How come we're back to Dora?
Well, we had Dumb Donald last time.
Let's have him again.
Well,
he's fun.
Oh, that's right. We switch back and forth, you see.
Okay, I love my answer. Empty.
Empty.
It's a sign, empty.
That's right. Nothing there. No, nobody home.
I want to get on with this because I have to go to the draft board. No, I believe you should do your duty.
Yes, of course.
My handbag, where is that?
Your handbag is right under the chair. Keep it down there. It's safer there.
I said vacancy or vacant.
Vacancy.
Yes.
Yeah. All right.
To rent.
Right. For rent. To let.
Yes.
What do you say, Fanny?
Oh, Durham, I'm sorry. I wish I had matched you. I said vacancy.
Vacancy. So. That's true. That's not bad for a first round, is it, Carol? That's pretty good. Okay. She's off to a good start. We'll see how you do in a minute or so. But right now, we've got this message for you. We're in round one. Gail has had her question. She's matched two celebrities. Now it's Carol's turn for her first round question. Goes like this. Gloria said last Christmas, Santa Claus must have been drunk. Instead of filling my stocking, he filled my blank. Santa Claus must have been drunk. Instead of filling my stocking, he filled my blank.
I think that.
There's one that comes to mind immediately.
Could that be it?
That could be it.
Instead of filling.
Well, I got more like Jenga. I got to win. Mercy, do.
Say it again. I didn't mean to sound so abrasive.
Gloria said last Christmas Santa Claus must have been drunk. Instead of filling my stocking, he filled my blank.
I don't like bad things said about Santa Claus.
Well, no, we're just funning him. You know, we all love Santa Claus.
He has no sense of humor.
Don't we, Ron?
Oh, God,
yeah. He's a very good man.
He's written me several letters and asked if we could please stop doing that to him.
Okay. Here we go. Charles, ready? Yep. Now, Carol. Gloria said last Christmas Santa Claus must have been drunk. Instead of filling my stocking, he filled my blank.
That terrible harness all us ladies wear, bra.
Bra. Do you? Oh, you do. Okay. Just checking. What do you say, Ron? She said bra.
Well, I was going to say bra, but then I figured...
But you're a little kid and you couldn't say that,
right.
Huh?
So I figured that why not get as much as you possibly could? So I said pantyhose.
Pantyhose.
I
must have been drunk instead of filling my stocking and filled my blank. All right, Brett, what do you say?
You know why he didn't say bra?
Why?
Nobody he dates wears one anymore.
You got a point there.
No, she's got two. I'm a rascal. Give me a chance. What do you
Remember
say?
Remember that terrible harsh thing? Well, yeah. Never mind. I said bra.
Bra. So that's one for Carol. Charles?
What was the origin of that beautiful Christmas saying?
What?
thank you for helping me.
What Christmas
saying? It was the origin of that beautiful Christmas saying.
What?
Which goes?
No, the what is better. It's shorter and it keeps it in meter.
Oh, all right.
It reminds me of that wonderful Christmas saying.
What?
My cups runneth over.
I see. No, it would have worked, might have worked if you said, my C cup, my C cup runneth over.
It's a D.
Speaking of D
really
cups.
Biggie. Oh, yeah. Aren't you cute to notice that with Fanny Flagg right down the street?
A group of D cups.
Instead of filling my stocking, you fill my blank. D-cups. And she said bra.
Well, since we're on the subject, bra.
Bra it is. That's sweet for her. I always said shoes. Instead of filling my stocking, fill my shoes, which seems like...
But it was a lady.
And you would have been wrong, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would have been wrong.
That's why you're there.
I would have blown the whole game. I don't know how to play this game. What do you say?
This is another thing I'm taking to the draft board with me.
Yes. Okay. And speaking of bras...
Everyone, everybody burned their bra?
Yeah.
They didn't have to run upstairs.
So, you know, usually first-round questions don't get those kind of responses, but you two gals are good players, and there you are. Now, Gail, you can have A or B.
B.
B. Two people do not play. Ron does not play, and Charles does not play. The rest of you, if you would, please.
Right.
Phil said, when I make my wife happy, she feeds me chicken soup. When I make her mad, she feeds me chicken blank. Phil said that.
There were a couple of really nice ones. There's that one.
Right.
And then, of course, there's that one. Which one do you think?
She feeds me, when I make my wife happy, she feeds me chicken soup.
When I make her mad, she feeds me chicken blank. Hi, hon.
Ready.
Ready.
You know we're all waiting for you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm here.
Hello, Gail. Phil said, when I make my wife happy, she feeds me chicken soup. When I make her mad, she feeds me chicken...
Feed.
What?
Feed.
Feed?
Yeah.
Have you got your ticket to Durham, North Carolina?
No.
I like that.
You'll be buying one soon. Brett, no, that was not a bad answer at all.
But, I mean, I have to write something down. Feed.
No,
I didn't say that. I'm sorry. I said chicken bones.
Chicken bones. That's all the others, Gail, to stay in the game. Joanne, what did you have?
Chicken feed means money. What's a good thing? And when she's mad, she gives him chicken doo-doo.
Chicken doo-doo. Well, my dear.
You said chicken, dude.
You did enjoy it. Good.
Yes.
We've got some gifts for you as a memento of your appearance here.
Thank you.
Gail Clower, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye, my dear.
Goodbye, goodbye.
All right, here, you recognize this thing? You know what that means?
Yeah.
That means you could win over $5,000. Let's see, if you won over $5,000, it would be over $15,000 for you. Right now, you got $11,900. Shall we begin?
Yes, sir.
Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Forever blank. Now, the answer they gave most often, remember, is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the second one, $250, and the third gets you $100. All right, pick them out one at a time.
Charles?
The role that Brett turned down years ago in pictures, Forever Amber.
Forever Amber.
Danny?
Hi.
Hello, darling.
You're so rich.
Yes.
Forevermore.
Forevermore.
Joanne, I think Forever Yours.
Forever Yours.
Oh, that's a good one.
So, you've got Forever Yours, Forever Amber, Forevermore.
Forever.
First thing I thought was forevermore, so I'm going to stick with first impressions.
Forever. You've read Edgar Allan Poe, have you?
Yes.
Who's booing out there?
What is what did the raven say? Nevermore.
Once upon a midnight dreary, while I pondered weak and weary over
Enough.
Many a quaint and curious volume.
His reading is going to
go to Seattle in a month.
Nevermore is what he said, really. I thought it was forevermore. It's not. Well, let's find out if forevermore is up there. May we see the $100 number? Forever and ever. Forever and ever. Okay. We are looking forevermore. May we see the $250 number? Forever yours. Who gave you that? Joanne gave you that one. Okay, last chance for forevermore. Slighted Earl. Forever Amber.
I get the chick up to 11,900 and she turns on me. The chick turned on me.
Listen, chick.
I'm sorry, Charles. I'll never do it again.
It's over.
It's over. No, it's not all over, Carol. You've got 11,900. You'll meet another player later, but right now we've got this message for you.
Chick.
Today's Constellation Prize is our first. From Amity, a ladies' three-piece ensemble featuring the ultra-French purse feels easily removed from hidden compartment through the change purse. Amity. And Z-Brick wall covering. Add color, character, and charm to your home with fireproof and expensive Z-Brick, America's most popular brick wall covering. And a cooler. And a Zavaya Fresca, that delicious, chilling, freezing, sugar-free soft drink that puts out thirst. Fresca. And a shopper's tote from Parsons Ammonia. Brushes every room, walls to windows, costs little, cleans a lot. Parsons, America's number one selling ammonia. The Blank Brothers invented the airplane, right? Orville and Wilbur Blank, right? These are little known facts you'll learn on Match Game 76 when it continues in a minute.
Okay. Here we are. We're ready to carry on. Are you ready to carry on?
Yep.
Would you all welcome Tony Taverna?
Hi, now.
Hey, Tony.
Hi. Tony, we want to find out where you're from.
A little bit about you, if you would please, sir.
Well, if I can say this, I'm an exceptional person in the sense that I'm 1 in 600,000. I weighed 16 pounds and a half when I was born.
What?
My mother said more than that.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm also one of 18 children.
One of 18?
Yes,
oh, you mean to tell me she did it again?
Were you the last?
No, I'm only the sixth.
You were the sixth?
That's right.
She didn't know when to quit when she was ahead, did she?
I guess so. And I'm presently retired.
Yeah?
The last job I had, I was city clerk in the city of Rome, New York.
Uh-huh.
And I'm here visiting my daughter, my son-in-law, and my grandson, Eric.
Obviously, your father has no hobbies.
Very well put, sir. Right. I'm enjoying my stay here very much.
Well, we're delighted to have you with us, Tony, and the very best of luck to you. Shall we begin?
Thank you, Gene.
Here we go. A or B for you, Tony?
A for Antonio. Oh,
A for Antonio.
Pies on.
16
See
pounds.
You, senor.
I've never heard of that.
Ask what he weighs now. Just curious.
No, I'm not going to ask.
Come on, what do you weigh now,
no.
Tony?
If he tells
January
you,
January the 6th, I weighed 261 pounds, and this morning I weighed 230.
Good for you, though.
Wonderful.
Very good.
The grandchild.
You
had the baby.
You lost two babies, huh? does that include the 16 of years ago, or what?
Yes, it does, indeed.
Well, I won't ever use that joke again.
Billy
You're
said,
dying, Charles.
Mom wouldn't let me have a dog, so I got a watermelon for a pet. Just as good as a dog. I already taught it to blank. Billy said, Mom wouldn't let me have a dog, so I got a watermelon for a pet. It's just as good as a dog. I already taught it to blank. That's the best answer.
I have it.
Okay. Very good. Splendid.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, there is no.
Good, good, good.
Good, good. Thank you, sweetheart.
Go over to Tony Taverna. Billy said, Mom wouldn't let me have a dog, so I got a watermelon for a pet. Just as good as a dog, I already taught it to...
Tinkle.
Tinkle? Tony, I think you missed the point of the question. Dogs already know how to do that.
Watermelons don't.
Thank you, Brad.
What did you say, Ron?
Roll over.
Roll over.
Sorry.
Watermelons roll over. What do you say?
I I say this may be a match, and it may come as a shock to the world.
To me, it will. If you match him, it's going to shock the heck out of me.
I said, but you taught him how to lift its little leg.
Oh, that's tickle.
That's one for Tony. Charles?
I don't believe her.
Show and tell, if you please.
This is a match. I would never let an Italian friend down.
Really?
Wet on paper.
All right. That's two for Tony. Tony, I got a level with you, pal. I thought you gave an absolutely rotten answer.
I think so he far, did. I can't. There's no denying that.
So far, he's got two out of three, and I'm looking like a dummy up here. What do you say?
Well, it is a rotten answer.
Really?
It's incredible how their minds work, because the only thing a watermelon could do is roll over.
Roll over. Okay, Richard.
Brett has obviously not given up drinking if she's seen a watermelon with a leg.
He got one out.
Now, Fanny.
We're making you feel a lot better because I said sit up and beg.
Sit up and beg. Okay. So, okay, Tony, you got two, and yours will be long in a moment. But right now, we want to pay the attention to this message or whatever. I don't know. Hold the phone. We got to stop right now.
Oh, no.
Can't go on. Yeah. So here we are in the middle of round one. He's done two. And when we get back, your first round quit. Can you stay over?
Most certainly.
Okay. Look forward to seeing you. And you were all just splendid. And we'll look forward to seeing you, too. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time. Match game 76. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Fixon, Bill Totman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.